I Okay. Please be seated. Okay.
All right. Any preliminary issues that we need to address before bringing the jury out, counsel?
Yeah.
This is a second. Please rise. Please be seated. We find the defendant not guilty of count one. We find the defendant guilty of child abuse recklessly caused or recklessly permitted resulting in death of child under 12 as charged in the second included offense of count two. We find the defendant not guilty of child abuse recklessly caused or recklessly permitted no death or great bodily harm as charged in count three. We find the defendant not guilty of child abuse recklessly caused or recklessly permitted no death or great bodily harm as charged in the alternative to count three. We find the defendant not guilty of child abuse recklessly caused or recklessly permitted no death or great bodily harm as charged in count four. We find the defendant guilty of child abuse recklessly caused or recklessly permitted no death or great bodily harm as charged in the alternative to count four. We find the defendant guilty of tampering with evidence as charged in count five. We find the defendant guilty of bribery of a witness as charged in count six. We find the defendant guilty of bribery of a witness as charged in count seven. Mr. Sorensen, does that accurately reflect the jury's verdict?
Yes, sir, it does.
All right. You can see it. Thank you. Would you like the jury polled?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Sigala, is that, as the court read those verdicts, does that accurately reflect your verdict?
Yes.
And to Mr. Sorensen?
Yes.
Mr. Gannis?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Munzer? Mr. Gary, the select school?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Blackwell?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Wild?
Yes.
And to Mr. Prebble?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Tappan?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Dingus?
Yes, sir.
Ms. Munzer?
Yes, sir.
Mr. Oliver?
Yes, sir.
All right, folks, thank you very, very much for your service. I know it's been long, 2 weeks, and so I just have a small token of appreciation for your service for us, and that's going to take you back into the jury room, and I'll be in there just a few minutes. All right. All right. Please rise for the jury. Please be seated.
do at this point is set a sentencing date. I don't know if we have that yet.
Yes, Your Honor. November 10th at 10:30 a.m.
I don't think that we'll set this in our normal sentencing docket. It'll probably be a special session. So,
yes, Your Honor.
All right, counsel, is there anything else that we need to put on the record before we recess this evening? I'm going to spend just a little bit of time talking to the jury and giving them a small certificate of their participation in the process and spending the last 2 weeks with us. Is there anything else we need to put on the record from the state?
Your Honor, just in light of the change of the verdicts, I'd ask for anyone to hold as the defendant's condition of release, since he is guilty of the first degree felony. He's serving mandatory time.
Your Honor, other than what I raised with the court before about his federal case that's pending, that's been waiting for resolution in this case, other than that, I'd ask the court for at least a minimal bond or an ROR or something to order the federal custody.
I don't think he's, I don't think the no bond hold is going to prevent him from taking him. I don't think so at this point. I don't know if this is going to be problematic, but I think I'd like to get through this and get through sentencing. So I'll hold him no bond at this point. Given the verdict of the jury, and then we'll go forward. All right. Counsel, anything else?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you very much.